Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing exponents and radicals. Let's start by doing some examples. The question is to evaluate. In part A, we have 2 over 2 to the negative 3. Let's work through it. Solution. So whenever you have something like this, 2 over 2 to the negative 3, what you can do is you can make that exponent positive by bringing the 2 upstairs. So this is equal to 2 times 2 to the 3. And now what you can do is you can add the exponents, because whenever the bases are the same, you can add the numbers. So you get 2, the 1 plus 3, which is 4. And then 2 to the 4th is equal to 16. There's other ways to do this problem, but this is a very common way and a very easy way, at least in my opinion. So whenever you have something with a negative exponent like this, you can bring it up and then you can add the exponents because the bases are the same. All right, let's go ahead and do another one. Part B, we have negative 3 to the 0 power. And this one's actually really easy once you know how to do it. Solution. Whenever you have a number to the 0 power, it's just going to be equal to 1. So the answer is just 1. And it's really that easy. So you have something to the 0 power, you're going to get 1. Let's do some more examples, but now let's start involving some variables. In this example, we are going to simplify. Part A, we have 2x squared, all being raised to the 3rd power, times 3 times x to the 0, and that's all being raised to the 2nd power. Let's work through it. Solution. So for this first factor here, 2x squared to the 3rd power, whenever you have a product like this raised to a power, you have to raise each factor to that power. So it'll be 2 cubed and then x squared cubed. And then over here we have 3, and then x to the 0 is 1, so I'll just write it there like that. And you can skip steps. I'm going to show you how I would do this in a second. I'm just showing extra steps. So 2 cubed is 8. And then here, properties of exponents, you basically multiply. 3 times 2 is 6, you get x to the 6. 3 times 1 is 3, and 3 squared is 9, so you just get 9. And 9 times 8 is 72, x to the 6. All right, so I would do this problem as follows. I would say this is equal to, you square the 2, so you get 8. You square the x squared, but we know we can multiply. So 3 times 2 is 6, so you get x to the 6. X to the 0 is 1, so it doesn't really matter, because 3 times 1 is 3. 3 squared is 9. So you get 72 x to the 6. So how much work you show is really dependent on what you want to show, but now you see two different ways of approaching the same problem. Let's do another one. Part B, we have 3 times the square root of x minus 2 times the square root of x. Solution. So basically, because we have 3 square root of x's and we're subtracting 2 of them, we're going to end up with 1 left. You basically just subtract the coefficients. So 3 minus 2 is 1 square root of x. But no one leaves their answer like that. They instead write square root of x. So very, very simple, even though it might look challenging. So 3 square root of x minus 2 square root of x is just 1 square root of x, which is the same thing as the square root of x. Let's do another one. In part C, we have the square root of 40. So this one is a little bit different. Solution. So whenever you're trying to find the square root of something like this that you don't know, you want to think about the factors of 40. So what's the largest factor of 40 that's a perfect square? In other words, what's the largest factor for which you can take the square root of that factor and get a whole number? Well, 4. Because you can write 40 as 4 times 10. So we can write this as the square root of 4 times 10. And then we can break this up into 2 square roots. This is the square root of 4 times the square root of 10. And the square root of 4 is 2, so this is equal to 2 square root 10. Just take a little bit of practice, and the more you do, the better. But that's the idea. You want to basically think about what's the largest factor of that number that you can take the square root of and get a whole number. Let's do some more examples. Part D, we have 16 to the 3/4. Let's work this out. Solution. There's a trick to work this out. I'm going to show you how I do it. So you have a square root and you put the 16 here. This right here, this number, goes right here in the little pocket. So you put the 4 there. And the 3, you can put it anywhere you want. You can put it inside the square root or you can put it outside. Better to put it outside. So again, that number, the 4, always goes there. And then the 3, you can put it wherever you want. So it's better to put it outside usually. The fourth root of 16 is 2, and then 2 cubed is equal to 8, and that's the answer. The formula, in case you want to see it, let me show you, basically says if you have x to the m over n, you can take the n, and that's going to be in the little pocket. The x goes here, and the m, you can put it on the inside or the outside. Usually it's better to put it on the outside. You can put it on the inside. You can put it here like this, but it's usually better to put it on the outside. Let's do another one just to make sure you got it. So E. So let's say we have, oh, I don't know. Let's see. 100 to the 3/2. All right, let's work this one out. Solution. So just like before, the 2 goes in the little pocket. So it's just going to be a square root. The square root always has the 2, but no one ever writes it. So if you don't write it, it's a 2. So that goes there. The 100 goes here, and the 3, let's put it on the outside. Root of 100 is 10, so we get 10 cubed, and so we get 1,000. Pretty powerful technique. Just remember that the number on the bottom goes in the little pocket, and you can put the number up top wherever you like. That's it. Hopefully you have learned some math in this video. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck and take care.